service agreement that a common attorney has as a requirement to talk about?
I wouldn't sign anything until she took a look at it.
Yeah, no, I think she should have a look at it, but yeah.
I mean, it's doing our due diligence.
Right.
I mean, if everybody's comfortable with sending it to her, I mean.
Yeah, I'm fine with it. I think, I mean, I know the feedback I got from the committee has been that we should move forward with this, so. And then if it does, you know, we do approve it, and it does, you know, become available in Dunbar, it's really, you know, the consumer at that point that gets to make a choice.
Exactly.
Which, you know, I like having choices sometimes, except when it's food, but not really. Too many choices.
Do we have this electronic over there?
Is that, would be easier sent to?
I think I have it. Haven't I given you the agreement?
I gave it to you, way back.
So when he, you're gonna forward this to the?
Yeah, we have them respond by next meeting.
Yes.
That'd be great. You're gonna ask her the question.
Yeah, yeah. I wrote here, if other companies come in, i.e. Comcast, Cable, are we bound to their agreement? Right?
Yeah.
Or do you want?
Do we have the, yeah, do we have the ability or flexibility to renegotiate and all that stuff that we're just talking about?
You wanna write it up?
I'll go over, I can show you.
I understand a number of towns use the same legal firm. I'm not sure, which Dunbar uses, but we, then we have this.
Mitchell Municipal firm?
I don't know. We've used this exact same agreement with the town of Washington, and they sent it to their council to review it. So if you use the same one, the lawyer would be familiar with it.
At least we move the stuff forward now.
Yeah.
That may have saved you some money.
Pardon?
It may have saved you some money, because it's the same lawyer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or at least the same group.
Yeah, amen.
Thanks.
Thank you.
You got anything else for us?
So I guess we have, we'll have our lawyer look at it, and then our next meeting we'll review it again, and forget if it's good to go, and we'll look and read the law, yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
Very good. All right, thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
Is he going off, are you?
No.
All right. Anything else on the, before we go too far?
I have Dave Knoll, which I love, I'll pay a type of copy.
Yeah, he's a no-show. You ready to start the box? Plenty of stuff.
Can I go over a couple of things?
Yep, if you're like.
I'll leave off my notes for the bid for draft two of the town hall library booth. Dunbar Elementary School, Jeff Tressa stopped in, and they are asking the town to waive the building on the fee.
Yeah, it's in here, you got it.
For.
It's in an email here, I thought it was.
Okay.
Yeah, we'll find it.
Okay.
You guys read that?
Yeah, I saw that, was it an email?
Yeah.
It's kind of standard for it to come in.
Yeah, and I don't have a problem with the town waiving the fees on the school.
Exactly, so. I'll make a motion, we waive the fees for the school construction project.
I'll second that.
Any discussion? I think we already had it. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
So very good. If you'd be so kind as to let them know that. Anything else for the world?
I think all spits in the basket, and then we're gonna review the second draft of the RFP.
I know we got John here, so before we get too far, I was gonna start with this mess. John. We got a whole big pile of stuff here, and it's got your name written all over it. Well, for you gotta stay back there.
I'm staying back here.
You shaking it?
Yeah, it's just the 911 mapping is completed. We reviewed the maps. We had some issues. They re-corrected the, a couple streets and road names that were different. So we reviewed it again. So now the document front is for you guys to accept the 911 address and mapping as presented, so the database can be entered into the 911 system.
Alright, ready?
That's day one, and that's pretty common. You know, there shouldn't be any issues with that. they've addressed the whole town, every house indicated on those maps, streets, what the house number is. And then they need to get that into the database, so when someone calls 911, they'll have that map in front of them and correct that. So we checked all that, Steve and I have gone over it, and there's no issues we found, second round. Next stage is, they've given us about 10-page letter of recommendations they want done in town. Addresses changed, road names maybe renamed.
That was one of my questions, like, it mentions it in this letter here, but we, there's nothing attached to it, no.
That's another part of it. The first part is getting this adopted, as that is right there, the maps and the addresses, and then getting them in the books. Because there might be some changes, if we agree in the next phase to have someone change their address, then, you know, obviously it has to be changed in that data right there. But that data as it stands is the first step of getting this process going and getting in the, into the database for the state. So it's just those documents you need to sign. Then we'll come back, then we'll get some other issues and down some people will be upset maybe, but you know, safety issues, some people have addresses that are definitely out of whack on different roads than they should be. There's a whole town, a road in town that the numbers are backwards from the rest of the town, odds and evens are on the wrong side of the road because certain selectmen.
Are you serious?
Selectmen went, time went down, numbered it on his own, and did it as backwards from the rest of the town. So, you know, that's a safety thing, yeah.
Yeah,
the whole town's one way, you got one road in town where it's just the opposite. But they, and they got some recommendations, it's not going to happen, you know, like renaming and renumbering.
It sounds like work, I don't
know. Certain roads. Doesn't make any sense. But, example, they want numbers to be in concession, so if you come out of Gosstown, say on Blackbrook Road.
Yep.
They want those numbers to work their way low to high from Gosstown to Dunbar. So you end up at Stark Highway with a real high number, which doesn't make any sense to us, the way we operate. We want our own numbers going the opposite direction when they get to the town line. It's just, you know, one of their recommendations.
So their recommendations are hard, fast.
Right. And
you got to do it.
Right. And they don't have the authority to enforce it. They can't come in and tell us we're changing the name of this road. Or we're changing somebody's house.
So it's up to us to decide if we can choose.
Right.
Or
right. Have to
so we can do
hearing.
Nothing or we can do everything.
Right. And looking at the 10 pages, probably a third, I would say, recommend we do some changes. But the majority of it is just, it's their format, their work, the way they do things. Like if the state uses a 50-foot increment in handing out house numbers, I started a program in Dunbar 15 years ago. I used 33 feet for every house number. You know,
that's what's called a concrete?
Well, a guy in the Boston designed a program.
Okay.
And there was nothing out there before, so it works well. But the state adopted 50 feet. So
it's smaller.
Some of the, you know, there's some issues like that. But,
yeah.
You know, we're not going to change our numbers to be 50 feet. Yeah. And the whole town is 33.
Yeah.
No, that means everybody just will have to change their number.
Yeah, and then there's some, like, multi-family buildings. We use letters for the apartments. Right, well, the state wants us to use numerals.
Right.
Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4. But there's another building on the property. Say there's two, there's an in-law apartment. We have some properties that are A's.
Yep.
There's another building on the same property. They want those to be. But, you know, so if you got, say, 96A, and you have 96A, two different buildings on the same property. They have another recommendation of a property right here in the center. They want us to, it's on the same piece of property as a group of buildings. They think we should give that a separate address, which we don't have that in our system now. And I don't, that doesn't make any sense to me whatsoever, because it's on a piece of property, behind the property. So anyways, this pages of this type of stuff that we need to.
So we're going to call through it and see what we want to
do. Yeah, like I said, some is good and some is, you know.
So will you go through that and then bring your recommendations?
And then you have to have public hearing so the public knows what you're proposing.
But not for this person. This portion.
Not for this portion.
This is existing conditions, everybody's address as it is today.
Right, that's a, they found it down right there. Like I said, we did have some road names that were off and location, a few things that they've corrected on the maps. But as every house number is today, it's on that map right there. So if we do make a change and they just go back in the database. Like since this map came out, a new house was entered, Mansion Road that they didn't have on this map. So they went back and put back in the house number.
But it's not on this map.
It is now.
Oh, it is now, okay.
Just because it was done recently. But anytime we do get a new house number right now, we just send the info, information to them, they just update it. But as that stands tonight, that's what they found when they did the count. Our numbers, street locations and house locations. You know, they have little symbols, some indicate an outbuilding, some indicate a house. And the ones that actually show the driveway is that the house is more than, I think it's 100 feet off the street. If it's 100 feet off the street, they actually show the driveway. If not, they just show the number of the building. As well, you know, it's all that data they collected and GPS. So we have a mass, we have a big map of that, and then we have the individual maps. And when they get done, there'll be like four or five maps. Fire gets one, police can't come off.
Are these available to you folks electronically as well?
Yep.
So you have something you have in a truck, for example, on an iPad?
You can,
sort
we
of
don't
thing.
At this point. But you get an iPad, yeah, you could, yeah. Definitely.
Yeah. So,
but it's big for our dispatch center.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
See, we're one of the, we're the last town in Capital Area not to have a map, and
really?
And then out of 22 towns.
Okay.
And so the dispatch has been bugging me for one time.
Oh, yeah.
You know, Dunbar's the last town, because I got to give them an actual, you know, we have to give them a map of our town. So when there's an incident, the dispatchers can look at the road. But this is so much easier for them. So they get a 911 call, address comes up, they're looking at it on the screen. So they can say, it's, oh, yeah, that's the house beyond which his name fell on driveway. And, you know, they can look at that information and relay it because they know the numbers.
So that all being said, I assume it's your recommendation that we accept it as is tonight.
Yep.
For this portion.
That portion.
Okay.
Then we'll work on phase two. That's when some people are going to have some heartburn.
Can but you just stop
yeah. You know, yeah. It's nothing unreasonable. Some of this is just public safety. You got to have the right address and number to get that emergency.
Absolutely.
Cool.
Alrighty then.
We need a motion.
So
I'll make a motion to accept, call it phase one of the 911 plan. That phase one, would that be correct?
Of the map part of it,
okay.
Map and addressing.
Map and addressing.
Is there a second?
No, sir. All
right, we got a motion and a second. Any discussion, gentlemen?
I have one question. These maps that we're looking at,
yeah.
Are they going to be available for the town office?
Sure. Yeah.
I mean, the maps we have now, they don't have the numbers or anything.
Correct, you have the property maps.
Are we going to replace those with
no.
These?
No, in addition to it.
You mean as a tax map, or are you talking tax map?
Yeah, tax map.
I bet you.
Because sometimes, you know, we had a girl go over all those maps and write down all the
numbers.
The numbers of the present owners. That
I bet you our mapping company can incorporate that in
there. Maybe overlay it or something.
Yeah.
Tax map. I mean, it actually shows that doesn't show anybody's property.
No, it just shows up.
Oh, okay.
Just
yeah, there's no property bounds,
right.
Just the number.
Yeah.
If I'm mistaken, the planning board is in charge of the tax map for the town. So it's their purview to decide what they want to do with that. That's not ours, that's theirs. By law, they're in charge of the tax map.
This has nothing to do with the property.
Don't
be taxed.
But I think it's a good idea to have, you know, maybe we can do some of the combination overlay. I mean,
yeah.
It wouldn't hurt. Because yeah. I know it's like in a lot of like plans, you have different layers.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so
that's the way it's set up now.
Yeah.
I know conservation's been pushing to try to get the overlay of the conservation easements throughout
mm-hmm.
the town as another map.
As another layer to it.
Yeah.
That would be a great idea. Maybe we can come into the 21st century someday. All right, we got a motion and a second on the table. Any other discussion or questions? Anything else you want to add, John?
There's just another, you see there's two, there's another part to it about the right to know. That's
yeah.
A different document. But
yeah, we got
they include the state law on why that's in
yeah, we got the acceptance letter here. Then we have the acknowledgement of non-standard addressing. Then we have data release agreement. So.
Yeah, that's the right thing. You want to use certain information to release from.
So it is. Alrighty. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. We have a map. Okay, between you or John, who's gonna let the folks know that update the database?
How can maybe.
As soon as they receive that document, they take care of it.
Okay, so they've got all the information, they just wait for these.
Yep.
Want this to look at or?
No, I looked at it earlier.
Got a home plan. Well, today's the 11th, right?
Okay.
11th of June, 2015. There's one. Sure. There's those.
It'll be this thing.
He's not doing it.
I'm sorry.
Where is? What day is June?
It's had a year.
That's it. Three line. Alright. Alright. This is, anything else we do the order or we set to the box?
I think most of what I had to give references in.
Okay. General Starks, Starks Inc. byway signage, we have 3 votes for number 1, we have 7 votes for number 2, and 3 for number 3. What are the votes? That's what I was saying. That's what we're talking about, folks. I don't know if anybody wanna weigh in on before we take and close the ballot box. These are the 3 signs for scenic signs that are supposed to go at the beginning of, beginning and end of Route 13.
Do you have a vote on it?
Yeah, it's General John Stark. We'll give you the opportunity while you're here, if you haven't already voted.
Pass that one, so we can vote.
Yeah, well, I'll write it. 1, 2, 3?
Make it even, make it a, on that kind of.
4.
Just kidding.
Yeah, scenic byway, yeah.
I'm just doing 4.
4.
Hold my hands, man.
Thank you, Mike.
Thank you.
1.
1.
Norm, 3. Number 3 for you? Norm?
4.
Number 2?
Yeah, can you get the U?
Number 2.
What is it now? Can I make it a tie or?
No, not till I see.
That's all right, I haven't voted, I don't think Tom has.
I haven't, no.
You did, right? Yeah.
2.
You guys can turn that light on if you want.
I'll take 1.
Well, behold, someone's listening.
Who turned that on?
1.
Oh, Lord, so much to be white.
Did you turn, is that what you did?
What did you say, 2?
No.
It was fine.
I don't know what it was.
That's what happened.
They don't know that, you can vote twice.
Did you vote already else?
Oh, no.
I'll take 2.
2 votes?
2 votes. 2 votes, exactly.
Uh.
1 vote.
honest with you, I'm not in love with any of these, but if I had to pick one, I guess I would have to say two, in all honesty.
I would like to make that. Where Dunbar has shown up on the, you know, like the guy from Dunbar.
Well, it's actually the perimeter.
It should be a heart.
Yeah.
I agree.
Or a star. Sign number one has 7 votes, sign number two has 14 votes, and sign number three has 4 votes.
Well, I guess we'll go with number two then, right? Majority rules?
Yep.
So we're gonna vote for sign two.
He said, he actually stopped in today and was pleased to see this on the counter, said the kind of wares doing the same thing, leaving it out on the counter.
I'm gonna pick, they're picking three.
I don't know, the other side's got a post-it on it, I don't know what it's.
I didn't want anybody telling in the, it's the same.
That's the town of Dunbar, so, do we each get the?
I mean, technically there are 3 of these mailed to us, one down for each.
Well, that'd just be mean.
Yeah. So, I'm running out of sentences.
Please do.
Is each town getting their own sign?
No, they got it.
Because Weddell has the general pointing at Dunbar.
No, that's the.
Or is that the Route 13 thing?
No, it's the whole route.
The whole route is this, so there'll be 20, 30 signs made up, and they'll be set up all around.
Alrighty, application for leave, request leave from, request leave for 7/6 to 7/10?
Yep, it's the second, the first full week in July.
We have a meeting that week, but then again, I'm also on vacation, so I don't know if you wanna move that one or not.
Are you talking cemeteries?
No.
Of the cemeteries will be that week too.
Yeah, well, I think I have a dance appointment that day, so it'll probably just be lovely shape.
I thought you were on cemeteries. Yeah, we can move.
Or that we could just, you can meet with our,
With that before?
Yeah, I think we're big boys.
Yeah, without Lean being here?
Yeah, we don't know.
Him.
Oh.
No, I didn't say I wasn't gonna be here.
No, so you were gonna be on vacation.
He said he's on vacation that weekend, that we're sitting around.
Yeah.
So I'll be around.
Yeah, we can start.
We can do that.
Lean, this is about you.
It is. Hey, she runs this thing, it's not us, trust me.
Alright, enjoy your vacation.
I will.
We'll just hit a phone, that's.
Don't do a thing we wouldn't do, if you do, don't tell us about it, of course. Because the chief might be listening. Alrighty. Let's see, we have the email regarding the BSMI Interware software check stuff. Do you wanna talk about that later or now, or?
We can do it right now, because it's pretty, pretty quick, actually. Last, I forget what night it was. When were we?
Last week.
Last week, it seemed like so long. I had a technology meeting here at Scott, and the only people showed up. And then Linda Landry joined us, because she was here. So, we really didn't have much of a meeting, but we did have a nice chat with Linda about the whole BMSI thing. And so what came out of that is I needed to contact Sandra, his last name, Rowe, over at Interware, because the Interware BMSI thing connected with him. And the conversation was around what kind of printer, what kind of supplies we needed to go forward with this program, because we're in the process of replacing one of this printer. So what I was told from the Interware folks is that their program requires a certain type of check stock, which you get from them, to allow you to print checks, but you also need to use something called Mica ink, or Mecca ink. And so whatever printer we buy needs to have that ink available also. So when we're doing that research on the printer, we want to make sure that we select a printer that...
A laser jet?
Has to be a laser jet, yeah, that's a must. But I was thinking about also, it ought to be, hopefully they have a machine that's easy to swap the cartridges in and out of, because you're not going to use Mecca ink, because I understand it's really expensive. So you get the stock, the card stock, or the check stock from Interway, go buy the ink from them, or you go buy it from our supplier, and then the there's some documentation that has to get in place with the state, and Linda had a copy of that the other night, I have a copy. And, but she's ready to go, it's just a question of, you know, getting all those pieces in place and having the board, you know, sign up to it. Linda wants to start off with the E-Reg first. The Interware folks are pushing us to do the reg, the dog licensing, and vital statistics. And they think that would just be a nice, easy step into this, you know, electronic transfer of data or doing business. Now, we aren't going to move to a credit card or anything like that right away. That will come in time, but we want to take baby steps here, have some successes with, you know, getting this online thing going. And the way that would work is the user at home would log on to the website, enter in their data, and then that check prints here at Dunbar Town Hall.
And then it goes to the bank.
And then that goes to the bank. So no cash being handled through the Interware software. All of this is tracked. It doesn't involve PAM. The treasurer doesn't touch any of this. It goes right from Linda to the bank.
Well, I know from previous discussions, I know there was some discussion about having PAM involved in all this. So
if
I guess
go to the credit card,
if
we go to the credit card, then she becomes a player in that whole mix. But until we take that step, she's not involved in this process.
Oh, I mean, before we take and jump off, even though it's a baby step, we want to get Pam and everybody and all the stakeholders involved.
Oh, absolutely, we do.
Because
we
have to take a baby step, and then also when you get to a roadblock and that brick wall.
We need to have all the players. You know, Judy will have a stake in this at some point, you know, as the tax collector. So absolutely, all the stakeholders need to have, you know, their turn at the table. But the thing that drove this conversation in the last week here is that we weren't even thinking about special ink and special printers, because we can all print checks at home. And you can take a picture of a check and you can process it. Well, apparently you can't do that with this software package. And the requirement of the bank is that you have this Mecca ink.
Well, for security purposes.
Yep, it is. And so we did, because when you do a check at home, it already, I mean, apparently, I don't know what they're telling me this, it already has that Mecca ink in it, but I don't know how that's possible. Because I have a laser jet printer that's using just standard ink. But
what if it's in the paper or something?
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. I don't print checks, so I don't know. Don't know enough about it. So maybe it is. Maybe it's in the stock that you buy. I don't know. But when you're doing this online thing, you're going to be entering a check, you know, your checking information, your router number, all that sort of stuff. So that's what's going to be printed here at the town office, and that check will go to the bank. So that's the baby step. And as far as cost, we can recover those costs as a fee. You can set those up and customize what you want to charge for fees. So if there's a, you know, for example, in a registration, you're going to have to mail something back to your consumer. So you want to cover those costs, you want to cover the printing of the check and the printing and the ink. And I don't know what the cost of these items are individually, but I would hope that they're minimal, so that we're not charging, you know, me $5 to go do this one. I'd be willing to maybe pay $3 or $4 or $2 or nothing. But and if you want something to nothing, you just come into the town hall. So that option doesn't go away, you still have that.
So your frugal monies will be here.
Yeah. And but you know, a lot of folks today they want that convenience of doing it from home.
Yeah.
The other side of it is it drives people to the town website. As we evolve the website, it'll hopefully people will come to the website to get more information about the town of Dunbar. You know, as they go forward, because we're hearing in the technology committee that they want communication, they want something to communicate with. So hopefully by driving people to the website, more frequently, that would be a good thing. So that's where we're at on that. So if you have any questions about it.
Well, my question was, you know, like the AP, you know, for the town and stuff, because I was thinking printing checks as in just in general, not realizing it was the print checks, so you can have some
the bank. Yeah, bank, yeah.
So appreciate that clarification.
Yep. And over time, Brian, once, you know, and I'm all in favor of doing this in little pieces, because otherwise people just get overwhelmed with change. So if we throw four things at them and they get overwhelmed with just one of them, the whole process could fail because they're not happy with it.
Well, I think a big part is communication.
Right, yeah. So I think if we do the little step and get, you know, some successes behind us, and people will like it, then they're gonna start asking for that next step. I hope, that's what I'm hoping happens. So that's where we're at the moment. So as we're thinking about replacing that printer, that's a key part of what we do, but I also want to make sure that we get a printer that's easy to change that cartridge. Because if it's a whole big disassembly process every time, that's going to be a big inconvenience for the town clerk. So if we can make it...
You could just use one of the other network printers as well.
Maybe. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe that's what happens. Maybe we network, you know, through Jim, maybe we network her printers differently. So she has one that's specifically used for this purpose. And if you're doing that, then that printer maybe doesn't need to be the photo scanner thing. Maybe it just needs to be an inexpensive printer that you can buy the same for.
Yeah.
So when we're looking at that, something to think about, talk about with Jim also.
Yeah.
You know,
he's coming in tomorrow, I'll talk about it.
Yeah, it would be easier just network her to a different printer here or there and then just buy a...
We do have that now.
Yeah, right.
She could literally print to the tax collector's office.
Yep, so maybe if...
And she has another backup.
Yep.
This other one that's dying.
Yep, so maybe that, you know, that next printer, maybe the one for this purpose here can be an inexpensive printer.
Yeah.
You know, it's something that's photo scanning and copying and expensive.
Right.
But if it just needs to be a printer, a basic printer, probably... Yeah, you can buy those at Walmart all day long for $100.
And then reserve the...
And then network her machine to that for printing those checks specifically.
Yeah.
So something is still to talk about. We're not there yet, but we're getting closer.
As we're getting closer, how close to inception are we looking to take and turn that switch for E-Ridge and dog license and all that?
Well, Linda has some paperwork she needs to do with the state, and I don't know where she is with that at the moment. Tomorrow?
I just got the approval this week.
Did she?
Jim's
excellent. So we're that close.
Cool. Could I ask a favor, whether it's a technology or you, or somebody that, you know, take draft up like a communication to all the stakeholders? I mean, I'm not saying like every single citizen, but I mean, you know, like for
people
like Judy,
in office.
Lean, you know, everybody in the office and those that might be involved with this, you know, just kind of align what we're doing, where we're going, so that if they have questions, that, you know, we have a point of contact.
All right, well, I'll have to reach out. I won't be able to do it next week.
No, I know you're wrong.
But the following week, I can get with Linda and get, maybe she can be a little blurb where she is.
Probably can have a bunch of people contribute.
And then I'll put out, like, a little blurb to everybody that includes where she is, and then we can have other folks give us some feedback. And, we'll reach out. I think it mostly affects the people in this building immediately. But I'll do something like that. Yeah. But if you have to wait like I'm back.
Yeah. Well, just, you know, because I know what changed, the biggest thing is
communication. Absolutely.
So if we can do that, keep everybody in the loop.
Yep. No, I know.
Feedback. Any other thoughts on that?
No. Should I say that?
All right, moving on then. Financial statements for year end draft. I don't know if you guys have looked at that or not.
Not
the manager letter. This is just basically all the numbers.
Deep dive into it.
We're just making a pile over here, or is it?
I
kind of stole it. I was reading the whole thing. But.
It's the standard?
It's the standard, basically, numbers. So I think we're with some categories were better this year, and other categories were a little less than we were. Was 71 grand ahead of where we were last year. Overall. Are you just looking for this, just a simple adoption for this tonight? No discussion.
Yeah. I know I saw
it. No, you didn't get a copy. I just got that.
Yeah, I saw it online, right? On email.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, this one. By email, just in a basket. I stole it for a day.
It's fine.
Oh, you did?
Yeah. Okay. What's that?
So why don't you make us coffee so we can...
You can have that one for later.
There's nothing that will change with this as far as my making you copies. I would personally like to move forward and have the auditor process the final draft, our final version, so that will get us closer to our exit conference. Because these are what they are.
These aren't changing.
Yeah,
so this
changing.
So this was a draft just for review?
Yeah.
Yeah, just make sure that.
And then you'll.
Well, I'd like to review it.
Yeah, I understand.
Yeah.
That's all I'm asking for, yeah.
I'll copy them, I can copy before you go tonight, so you'll have something to read.
You wanna copy?
No, I don't have your own, I don't have an opportunity.
Well, then if you don't need to copy, I'll just give them that one.
Okay. That's a good idea, because you've already read it.
Yep, I'm good with it.
Okay.
Yeah, I seen it on Tuesday, and I grabbed some stuff that I want, because I know it's a long one and.
The one I got was the management.
Yeah, we all got that one.
That one just came in.
That one just came in like yesterday or something like that. That came in a couple days before that.
Because of the number of pages, I didn't print out the 5 copies of the draft. Because we're gonna be getting a final version of it, that will be needed.
Ten, 12 pages, 30, well, technically 31 pages. So you divide, you know, double sided, you're talking 16 pages.
Yeah.
Save the tenths one. Lena's gonna say, the form that's correct from, based off the Department of Labor's information regarding, recording pay, rates of pay for people, the employees of the town.
Yep, and I saw that form, yeah. So this is the state that's driving this?
This should really be part of the personnel file, and it should be updated as there are changes or increases in pay. That way, the employee's signing off on it, everybody agrees that that's the pay.
Excellent, so annually, they would then review the package?
Yep.
Well, whenever there's an increase.
Or an increase.
Yeah, yeah.
Alright, so a minimum, it would be annually, but if there's an increase in the interim.
Right, we have certain individual that just passed a degree in education, you got a 50-cent increase, and I give you a full cover sheet that you sign off on, but it's not enough to put something in each.
Yeah, no, this is a good idea.
Well, by law, we're supposed to do, when we hire somebody, we're supposed to have, you know, they're supposed to get a document saying, here's what you've been hired for, here's your rate of pay, and this is when you're gonna get your paycheck, and blah, 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 blah.
Yeah, no, it's a good idea.
So, this. Ironically, state doesn't do that.
So I'll be working on, filling those out, distributing them, getting everyone to sign them so we can get there.
Nobody's gonna do this, your supervisor, let them, hunt them out.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
So, they'll get a copy of the latest personnel policy along with that.
Yep, yes, yep.
I'll make a motion, we adopt the, form that Lena has provided us tonight.
I'll say.
Dunbarton employee rate of pay sheet, I guess you call it.
I'll second that.
Alright, any discussion? No, hearing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
So you have an adopted form.
Okay.
Alrighty, we have, the Gene Drive, is it? Property, we have a letter from John Retig, how do you pronounce it?
Retig, yeah.
Retig, Mark's father, they've been trying to settle this matter with the insurance company, I guess they're engaged with an attorney, and they cannot discuss the case, so I assume it's going to court or negotiations. Since the fire, we have been paying the mortgage on the property, property taxes and attorney's fees. Therefore, we cannot afford to remove the existing structure at this time. Once Mark's claim is resolved, the insurance company will promptly move ahead with the destruction of the burn structure and cleaning up the lot so it can be sold. I'm in hopes this matter will be resolved in the very near future. If you have any questions or need additional information, please feel free to contact me. That being said, he didn't say he'd come in to see us.
He did.
Oh, he did?
I spoke to him verbally. I said this is a good start, but the selectmen still need to meet with him, so he will be at our 25th.
Okay, so.
25th? Yeah, June 25th.
Can we let the other folks in the neighborhood know, so, because I'm sure they're gonna wanna be here for that.
I already got a call from Lynn today, and I did tell him, and then Ed was here, so he was told, so.
Yeah, because he saw me at the dump and, for a transfer station, sorry. Old habits die hard. And he was grilling me on that, and I said, you know, gave him the letter, and they have the option to come in this meeting or the next one. So we'll know more by the end of the month, so he's probably here to see that.
Yeah, he's hoping something will be resolved by then.
No, no, what he's got to go with his glasses.
John, this gentleman, said that he's hoping between today, he may act from yesterday. And the time he meets with you on the 25th, he has more information for us.
Yeah, that'd be nice to move that thing forward.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know if that was next to me, that'd be going out of my mind, I'm sure.
Pulling the arrow?
If I had.
We had you back for that Kelsey Road quick this afternoon.
That was a good one.
Yes, it was. As we know, everybody knows, we get that issue going on with Kelsey Road. The maps that we just approved, he looks at us, oh, look at this, they got Kelsey Road going all the way to Bowen. I'm like, what?
Kelsey, don't.
Where does it say by the end of the month?
I said this was okay for him to submit this, but the selectmen still needed to meet with him to discuss a plan of action. And he said he's hoping that when he comes to visit you on the 25th, that he will have more information. So he's scheduled.
Are we going to notify the abutters?
I already spoke to one today. I just spoke to Ed now because I didn't get a chance to send them an email, and I'll be sure to the other.
Seems like they're
next month.
Yeah, they'd like to see that go away.
Yeah, I'm sure they do. Thank you, ma'am. All right, we have an on here from the use of the Town Hall Theater. My name is Matt Calhoun. I'm the artistic director of the Theater Kapow, a Manchester-based theater company. For the past 3 years, we've been holding artists retreat in Chancellor Gardens, Kenneth Sue Clover's property. Basically, they're going to start up again on July 12th through the 18th, and they're looking for use a Town Hall Theater space. I suggest they reach out to us. I guess I'm no more than 15 people taking part of the workshop. I know it's supposed to be on a Sunday, so they're willing to take and put us on their insurance binder and all that. I don't know if that came through by email. That was just for your application, folks, so we're aware of it. Entertain discussion.
Well, you know, the building is not in use.
Yeah.
I don't think we can accommodate.
can't use the upstairs.
Right, that's what I said too. Myself.
Like an egress.
Yeah, exactly. Right. Well, no, we've already shut it down to everybody else.
It doesn't mean code, yeah, I mean, yeah. Tons of people can't use it, so why would somebody from the outside want to use it?
Exactly. So I think that was a pretty quick, simple answer on that one.
Yeah.
Thoughts about sending to the school for use of the
Well, we could
gym.
Do that. We could offer them to contact the school. I know that they were, I don't know if it was in this email or not, but I know one of the things that they were concerned with or wanting was to be able to use a hardwood floor.
They got a hardwood floor in the school, in the gymnasium.
Hardwood?
Yeah, that's
what. Oh, the basketball court.
Yeah.
I was thinking it was tile. Thank you. Yeah.
Well, used to be way back when I was a little guy. Yeah. They didn't actually have a gymnasium there. They called it a multi-purpose room.
Yeah.
So the
answer is
no?
The answer is no. Since it was addressed to me, you want me to send them back the email?
Yeah, I think it made its way to Brian.
Yeah, I can do that.
Before we move on though from that subject, I do have still on this subject, because I was curious what Kapow was, and so I did a little work, and Theater Kapow, they run, you know, they do plays and what have you, but on their website, there's an advertisement that they're going to be coming here to Dunbarton for a summer retreat, July 12th through 18th, and the retreat's going to be at the, I'm not sure what it is, the Chantelier?
The Curbs,
okay. But they're going to be using the barn as one of the facilities, and there's not going to be any food used or anything, you know, other than bring your own. But they're going to be using, according to, you know, the information on the website, what to bring, water bottle, change of clothes, bathing suit, sunscreen, bug spray, body, body, all that. Meals, you're on your own, and they list some places. But, you know, and I'd like to encourage them to do this, but I'm wondering about permits. Is it a function hall? Is it, you know, and parking is on Route 13, and that'll be fine as long as they stay, you know, on the proper side of the white line, I guess. But I was just kind of wondering if there's any legalities here that the Kapow or the Curbs need to be concerned with.
Do we want to bring the Curbs in? It's their property, right?
Yeah, I know. This is not until July, so we have a little bit of time to get more information on it. But there are fees being charged by Kapow. I don't know if the Curbs are being reimbursed for the use of their facility. I don't know. But, and I don't know what, you know, what the rules are here in town for that kind of thing.
I don't know.
But if it's a, but if it's an assembly, you're gonna use that building for the assembly, may advertise it, charging public money. I don't know, I'm not sure. I'd like to encourage them to do that. I don't wanna get in the way, but I wanna make sure that nobody's, you know, setting themselves up here for liabilities, including the town. So I'm not sure where that falls.
Get John involved?
Yeah, I don't know.
Possibly Ken has a thing where, I mean, they oversee that kind of stuff as well.
I don't know how this is different than us on the common or anything like that, you know, they've done it in the past, except that it's outdoors. But this, if they, you know, this is gonna be indoors and outdoors.
Jerry, when that's a common, that's.
I know, and this is on private property. And I know this is before my time, but I know that Arbutus Farm went through a big deal when they wanted to turn that into like a function hall. And I don't know the whole backstory, but I know I can for sure end up in court, didn't it?
A special approval for that?
They went to special exception.
Was it?
Or it did?
Yeah.
To do what?
To have weddings and functions at the property.
Oh, you're talking about.
Arbutus Farm.
Arbutus Farm.
We're talking about.
I know that, but I brought up.
Did they get special exception?
Who, Curtis?
Yeah.
No. I've never heard of it.
Now, far as like businesses and stuff, licensing and all that sort of stuff, I think that's kind of the thing that you're going down.
Yeah, I just.
What we have under our zoning is a home occupation.
Home occupation's right.
I don't know if a home occupation would apply to that.
No, I don't think it would.
Cause this, to me, it's like, this falls under like function hall.
Yes, site plan review, we just had the church go through it for our thrift store.
Yeah.
And the church would come to the zoning board, except they have a court decision that says, grandfathered use.
Right. So I don't know, not trying to cause trouble for anybody yet, but I would like to make sure that everybody's doing the right thing. Because if these folks, you know, are doing this, there's nothing to stop them from picking other location in town and doing the same thing. And pretty soon you've got a lot of these things going in town with no oversight and then you'll potentially maybe leave yourself out of it in the town.
Yeah, because we let it happen.
Well, I don't know, cause I'm not collecting the money, but I think they are planning on a dozen, I think, as I said here.
They sell $25 a day and $100 per week.
Yeah, it was $25 a day, $25 for the week. And there's a schedule. I don't know if it says here, did it say in the email, Brian? I think in the email it did. I think they had a number in there.
15 people?
15, yeah, it's not a big group, but.
Yeah, so they'll have no more than 15 people taking part in that workshop. I don't know about the rest of the workshops.
Yeah.
But I mean, I would assume they said.
And I don't have a list of the workshops. They did have a list on their webpage, but I didn't print that out. See, daily sessions including a combination of movement, voice, object work, improvisational and composition, training with company members in Michael Chekhov method, viewpoints, voice, psychophysical improvisation.
It's all Greek to me.
Tai Chi, dance, marionette puppets. Ooh, can't wait for that one. That clowns. Yeah.
I've got enough of those.
I will for that one. And, I'm afraid of both of them, Ted. They scam me.
One, two.
Well, I don't know. I don't know how. I mean, and they do state on here the parking is on the 13th.
Oh, this is definitely one of them.
Yeah, so anyway, I would like to encourage them to go forward, but I also want to make sure that they're
send them right back.
Can we see if the Kermans are available on the 25th?
Yeah.
Down barn.
Well, I don't think this is the falling down barn. I think it's the other barn, the newer barn.
What did Jerry Williams do? He used to have retreats and everything, didn't he?
Pardon?
Every summer, Jerry Williams, the potter, didn't he have retreats down there?
Probably did.
He did.
This is a new era, though, I guess.
This is the first time that they've ever done this?
I don't know. They say that's
just pick up the phone. You don't have to call them.
I don't know.
Call up Mr. Kerber. Call up Mr. Kerber tomorrow.
Well, I didn't follow you.
I think he might have come to the zoning board.
Yeah, I don't know.
Well, can we do something?
Jerry Williams did? But you've never heard from Kerber, though.
Oh, no. They've been advertised on the internet, though, for some time.
Have they?
If you gentlemen don't have a problem with it, I was going to suggest that we have Steve and John do some research on regarding the home occupation, this whole thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, before we go too far and see where we
stand. Well, because you know what, this may just be the first one, maybe others to follow. So it might not be a bad idea, no.
I mean, before we, you know. Let's get a ducks in a row on our end first before we start hauling them.
Yeah, maybe they're just fine.
You got all that stuff from this link on this.
I did, yeah, I did a little deep dive.
I'll get that for Steve and John.
I get curious.
I mean, far as the, you know, on the rules and zoning and all that stuff, you see where we fall.
It's almost unfortunate they even sent out the email, because they don't really have a work. But they know it forced me to do something, so I just do it.
I understand. Alrighty.
Easier to say, I'm sorry.
We have,
You can handle this, Allison.
I noticed that the town clerk will be closed on Wednesday and Thursday, June 24th and 25th. And Tuesday, June 30th, should be closed for training from 11:45 to 1:15. June 24th and 25th. Town clerk will be closed.
What's the next one?
June 30th, it's a Tuesday. And it's from 11:45 to 1:15 for training. I see she did change her message. It says from budget cuts initiated by the Board of Selectmen approved by the legislative body at the 2015 town meeting. Results in less than 60 hours of deputy coverage for the remainder of the year.
That's fine. Yeah, that's what we asked her to do. So that's good.
So if you can change it, that's good.
Yeah, thank you.
So.
I said I need a break.
You
should sit in these chairs.
We can recess.
Why don't you guys sit here? We'll sit up in the slot.
Go right ahead.
Oh, we got this RFP then.
Good night, everybody.
Good night,
guys. Nice. Recycle.
Good.
What's your name again?
I didn't get that the first time. I just got
less
that
common at the end of the day. Less common at the end of the night.
That's true.
Oh, you get your cushion this
you got your
oh
cushion.
No, I get in trouble if I forget this.
Bus rider with a cushion.
Session, I guess.
Thank you.
We can probably close through some of the stuff. We've got the easy stuff. Bonding our employees. There was something regarding our discussion that business operation assessment and this whole stuff about bonding. According to the email that Lean received from Brian McDermott, I assume it's from our property liability folks, that anybody that, in summary, says that. On the forms of our policy, there are the summary of amounts of protection sheet that includes every employee handling money for the town. It's called the blanket bond protection, which by law we're supposed to have. And it covers the town for per loss up to $500,000. So those folks are all set. They handle money, they're already bonded.
Yep.
So we're good. Stamp on.
You're bonded.
Sure.
I'm good.
Steve Warren sent us another alternate for the zoning board. John Troyer is okay. John Hurley is requested to be appointed as an alternate on the zoning board. So we have another one for the zoning board.
We're on the zoning board now. Bunch.
That's what, a board of five, right?
There's a board of five, and we have two alternates, but one, when you make recent.
Oh, okay, yep. Yep.
So right now you only have one alternate?
We only have one alternate.
What does the alternate do? What if it says duty?
It covers if somebody accused himself. Like I've accused myself last, the other night.
Yeah, okay, so they would.
Well, then if they're absent, you know, they need a one for the board.
Yeah, okay.
Fill in.
And the alternates, observe and participate, but they don't vote.
Yeah.
I guess they're covering some of that.
Yeah, then it's put in the minutes that they are serving at that point in time, right?
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's fine.
We don't have the alternates for planning board, do we?
Not anymore, we used to. Jeff was an alternate, but then he became a full-time member.
Because you got what? You got Ken, George, you, Chuck.
Jeff.
And Jeff, that's five. Well, yeah, but they would need to make six, so it'd be, it's not, it's an even number.
We don't have any alternates.
Well, I know, I mean, isn't it supposed to be about number four? Should it be five, including the selectmen's role?
It should be.
So one of them should be an alternate.
Well, I think they want to have seven and one alternate. I don't know if Ken wants to.
We can only get the next planning board meeting, just but now that it's brought up, I just did the math in my head and it makes sense. Is there a motion to appoint Mr. Hurley to the zoning board as an alternate?
I'll make a motion to appoint John Hurley as an alternate.
Do we want to want the term?
Choose 3 years.
Right, but I mean, don't you want to alternate or something like that? So then it all.
Yeah, what's the rotation now? How's it working currently on an alternate? Are they in there for 3 years as an alternate, or is it
usually
less than that?
We just nominated one for a 3 year term, so put him for 2 years, or whatever you want to do.
Yeah, if you just so they're not alternating at the same time, might make sense.
Yeah, just so that they're
staggered. Yeah, staggered. If the other one's already in there for three, then make this one for two.
Okay.
And that way they're not coming up at the same time. Because if they're hunting for two alternates at the same time, that may be difficult.
Yeah.
It's hard to get people sometimes.
All right, so your motion is to appoint John Hurley as an alternate for a 2 year term?
Yes.
Is there a second?
Second.
A second on the floor. Any discussion?
No.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Dumbarton pole placement, we have that here. I guess everything got approved, so
yeah.
The buntings and the flag poles and all that stuff in the door. We
yeah.
have gone up, right? For the most part?
For the buntings, I think, and the building, most of them are up, right?
Yeah.
These are for the telephone poles. Dumbarton Telephone did say they check their schedule when they get free time, they're going to come in and do it.
Is
so the fixtures itself will get applied to the pole and stay there. And the permit itself is for a 6 month period.
That's what the original permit was signed.
Which has already been approved.
That's what got approved.
So the hardware will stay there forever,
mm-hmm.
but the permit's only good for 6 months?
Yep, so that if they watch to go back every year.
Oh, they do.
And review, and so they can come out and look at the site and make sure.
Oh,
all
right.
The
okay.
Locations are.
Makes sense. Cool.
So they approved that plan.
Is there a plan to have any professional photography of that building done once it's all decorated up and looking like it did 200 years ago?
I would think we're going to work on getting advertisement into that that local paper, Allison, and then we have access to the Goffstown News, a reporter usually.
Yeah, well, what I'm thinking about, I know that.
Well, they do a press release.
Yeah,
that would
be
yeah.
a press release too. But I was thinking that
I just did a little press release to go into the town crier, but that wasn't.
Yeah, but we're covered with Union later on.
Yeah, Copper Monitor.
Yeah, but I was thinking more of a professional picture for the forever record.
Mm-hmm.
That could also go into the time capsule.
Yeah,
yeah, it could go on the cover.
Year.
But no, I mean in another 100 years from now when they do the next thing, they would have that picture to go back to.
Could be the cover of the next town the report.
Yeah.
Could be. I could do a selfie out in front of it.
Yeah, it's not going to be the cover.
Just suggesting.
Yeah.
For photographer for that?
I'm just wondering, but you know, I know we have people in town that, do that.
Like Hanson does a good job.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, maybe somebody would even volunteer to do it.
Yeah, me too.
And maybe we can shoot for that lawn party date, August?
Yeah, could even do it when there's a group of people.